Welcome back to our DIY series of videos. This is Juan with Cable Wholesale. One of our most frequently asked questions we get on our support line is, how do I get internet to a second building on my property? You can get internet access to a workshop, detached garage, or ADU in a few simple and inexpensive steps. The solution we're detailing today uses copper Ethernet cabling. It is important to note that the maximum distance you can cover with this solution is 100 meters or about 328 feet. Just remember, it's a 90 meter run plus 5 meters of stranded patch cord on both ends. If you need to send a signal any further, fiber optic cabling is an option, and we'll be tackling that in our next video, so stay tuned. The star of the show in this application is the Cat 6 Ethernet cable. Cable Wholesale carries an outdoor, direct burial rated version. Let's take a look at the cable. The outer jacket is made of a UV-resistant polyethylene. The layer under the jacket is waterproof tape that adds moisture protection when the cable is deployed. These features add up to a cable that can be run outdoors, exposed to sunlight, and buried directly in the ground without using conduit. With an operating temperature rating from negative 76 to 96 degrees Celsius, whether you're in the hot southwest, the cold northeast, or anywhere in between, this cable is designed to handle extreme weather. So on each end of the Ethernet cable, you run from one building to the other, you will connect a punch down keystone. On the side of the keystone, you'll see two wiring diagrams, 568A and B. You'll want to follow the B diagram. The four pairs of the Ethernet cable have to be untwisted, straightened, and placed into the corresponding slots matching the B color code. Then with our punch down tool, we will terminate each conductor into the keystone. If you need a step-by-step guide on how to punch down an Ethernet keystone, we'll have a video in our library that we'll link in the description below. So in the main building, you will either have a router or switch you will use to connect to the direct burial Ethernet cable using a jumper or a patch cord. So let's say this is a 300 foot run of our direct burial Cat 6 cable. In the second building, you'll repeat this process and we will use a patch cord to connect the direct burial cable to a second switch. So once we're all done, we can connect any Ethernet compatible device and start using the internet. So here we have a laptop with no internet signal, and once we connect it to everything, I can now search the Cable Wholesale site. Thanks again for joining us today. This has been Juan with Cable Wholesale. Remember, our tech team is available by phone, live chat, and email from 8 a.m. Eastern to 5 p.m. Pacific, Monday to Friday. Make sure to tune in for our next video, which will cover getting internet connectivity to a second building using fiber. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.